ensure justice to the minorities. With these few words, sir, I conclude. Thank you very much.
Shri Jayaji T. Natarji.
Honorable Deputy Speaker, sir, unemployment is a ticking bomb and it affects the whole socio-economic fabric of the society and country. In a vast country like our India, employment generation is very important to keep peace in the society. Otherwise, the economic disparity and inequality will rise among the working class and unemployed youth, which lead to social injustice and unrest. Therefore, any steps taken by the government to increase the employment opportunities is welcome. The government's infrastructure development project and social welfare schemes can generate at least 50 lakh jobs every year, absorbing nearly half of the 1 crore people who annually entered the country's workforce. The pace of job creation is often considered an important parameter of the government's performance. The country has already been suffering a lot due to the huge backlog of unemployment, and its increasing trends continue to plague our country in the last 2 decades. According to the budget documents, the estimated workforce of central government establishment will be 35.05 lakhs as on March 1st, 2018. This is 2.53 lakh more than the head account of 32.52 lakh in March 2016. About 1 lakh more workforce is estimated to have added in police department under the Home Ministry to take the total head count to 11,25,093 by March 2018. About 30 lakh jobs are expected to be created under the budgetary allocation of rupees 1,600 crore for rupees for 2018-19. Under Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Prasthapita Yojana, the public sector and private sector companies play a crucial role in the employment generation in the country. But still, lot of gap exists between employed and unemployed population in the country. There is an urgent need to address the rapidly increasing unemployment and underemployment condition in the country. For example, in my Thoothukudi constituency, with salt producers citing a declining market, industry workers in Thoothukudi see themselves making no headway in getting better life this year. Salt production, which involves a seasonal workforce, in the mainstay of the local economy. However, most of the workers relying on the industry live below the poverty line. I urge the government to take into this serious issue and sanction a special package for the development of salt pan workers of my Thoothukudi parliamentary constituency. The river Kaveri is the lifeline of Tamil Nadu, particularly the millions of farmers in the Delta region in Tamil Nadu. The people of Tamil Nadu are sad that the Union government had failed in its responsibility to constitute the Kaveri Management Board as per the orders of the Supreme Court to form the Kaveri Management Board in 10 days. With this notification, the final order of the Kaveri Water Dispute Tribunal, the scheme for modernization of the canal system in the Kaveri Basin at the cost of rupees 11,421 crore may be accorded approval. The Tamil Nadu government had submitted the proposal of the Central Water Commission for the extension, renovation and modernization of Grand Anaikatt Canal at the cost of rupees 2,610 crore. The commission also gave the in-principle consent. I urge the government to consider this important proposal and allocate the requested fund for the implementation of Grand Anaikatt project. The government of Tamil Nadu had sought the assist of the Union Government for implementation of the proposal to divert the flood waters of Kaveri to drought prone areas by linking the river Kaveri, Vaigai, Gundar at the cost of ₹5,166 crores. This project proposal should need to be approved and supported by the Union Government. Tamil Nadu is one of the leading states in India in fisheries department, having coastal length of 1,776 kilometers. I request the Honorable Finance Minister to release ₹3,000 crore for the development of fisheries in Tamil Nadu. The Department of Fisheries in Tamil Nadu has pioneered many fisheries department activities in India. The Union Government has promised to form a separate ministry to develop and conserve the fisheries resources. I wish the government will create a separate ministry for fisheries and development of fishermen community in the country and focus exclusively on the subject to provide a permanent and everlasting solution for the problems faced by the fishermen community. Animal husbandry, dairy and fisheries sectors play a very important role in the socio-economic development of the country. India continues to be biggest milk producing country with an impressive growth rate. Cattle rearing needs government patronage, and as rightly implemented by Prachitalavi Amma, the distribution of priceless cows, goats and sheep to cattle rearing people in Tamil Nadu has indeed produced remarkable success in the socio-economic development of poor and deprived people, particularly in the village and remote areas. Sir, coming to my Tuticorin parliamentary constituency, the work on the much awaited 1,320 megawatt supercritical thermal power project at Udangudi in Tuticorin district, proposed with financial support from the centre. The proposed 2×660 megawatt coal-based supercritical thermal power project will improve the power infrastructure in Tamil Nadu. The Rural Electrification Corporation has come forward to provide a loan of 1 lakh crore to Tamil Nadu Generation and Distribution Corporation to augment production by setting up new projects, and ₹1,000 crore has been sanctioned for the first phase of TTPP at Udangudi. Now this needs a separate exclusive captive port for handling coal also. The Tuticorin Airport needs to be expanded. A total of 600 acres had been identified for the expansion of Vagaikulam Airport from adjoining villages including Kumaragiri, Kattalangulam, Mudivethanendal and Sirvaikaran Madam. The district administration has already handed over 366 acres of Patta land acquired as per the Land Acquisition Act to the Airport Authority of India. I urge upon the Union Government to expedite the expansion of the Tuticorin Airport. The East Coast Railway, the railway line from Karaikudi in Sivaganga district to Kanyakumari via Tuticorin, Tiruchendur and Kudangulam is a long pending demand of the people of southern Tamil Nadu. The route is very essential with power plants coming up at Udangudi and Kudangulam. Moreover, several temples are located in towns along the route, attracting thousands of pilgrims every year. Also, it could be an alternate and shorter route to Kanyakumari. I urge the Union Government to take up the East Coast Railway line and accord top priority. This is an urgent need to start a Kendra Vidyalaya school in my Tuticorin constituency. I wish the government would fulfill these demands in this year. With no sufficient gains for the salaried class and higher income taxpayer reeling from the additional tax burden, the only section of the society that seems to be rejoicing is senior citizens. Most of the initiatives in the Union Budget 2018 is done keeping in view of the next election, which is round the corner. There is no much substantial for the productive state like Tamil Nadu or Maharashtra but substantial for northeast and north Indian states. Budget 2018 is short of substance and will not fulfill the hopes and expectations.